It doesn't help that sometimes I hear capitalism blamed for things that clearly non-capitalist institutions are doing. So capitalism causes war. But how could it? I mean, no corporation would have the pockets deep enough and would be able to brainwash the public into thinking that they're somehow a legitimate ruler that can tax you and whatever. I mean, no one's propagandized into believing that about Exxon or anything when they're in school. So we get that, or we get the World Bank is somehow must be for capitalists. Or I cannot get over this. Richard Posner, who was like a right of center judge, Richard Posner wrote a book called A Failure of Capitalism after the financial crisis of 2008. And when you ask him, but the Federal Reserve is obviously not a capitalist institution. It's not privately funded or established. It was created by Congress. How could it be? And his answer was, yeah, but it's a part of capitalism. What does that even mean? So it's extremely unclear, and it doesn't help.
Yeah, I mean, basically, it's just that vague, meaningless definition where anytime you see someone benefiting, anytime you see someone taking a profit, or anytime you see someone doing things allegedly, you know, for themselves and not for this vague ideal of society as a whole, it's labeled capitalism. And it makes it very easy to agitate, you know, against people that have things that you don't. It makes it easy to create narratives. It makes it easy to gather crowds. It makes it easy to fundraise for political movements whenever you can agitate like that. And so capitalists and capitalism is a boogeyman. And when you call things that people don't like capitalism, it's so easy to cast it in a negative light, and you can use it to your advantage. I mean, that's the way I see it.